And we're live. What's up, Revo Nation? Have you ever wondered whether sociopaths are born or created? Well, we'll answer that later in this video. We'll teach you how to spot a sociopath with six common identifiers, and make sure to watch until the end of the video for a bonus trait. Number one, sociopaths are generally very good at determining what people need and then manipulating others into believing that they can provide that.
The first was that, if possible, it would be extremely valuable to the ecosystem to backstop some of these places. First of all, it's just backstopping customers and making sure they're protected. But second of all, stopping contagion from spreading through the ecosystem, right? Stopping it from being the case that...
And there are four manipulation tactics that they'll often use. The first one is that they'll target vulnerable people. Most sociopaths target vulnerable people. But if you do your due diligence and take time to find out what someone's about, most really intelligent people can spot a sociopath with enough training and information, as long as there isn't an emotional attachment. That's because when you have an emotional attachment, your perception can often be skewed. The second thing that they do to manipulate is that they often quickly apologize. Sociopaths may give sincere sounding apologies because they know that an apology can quickly disarm people. They've learned this. The third thing that they use to manipulate is gaslighting. Gaslighting techniques are used by toxic people to manipulate and disempower their victims. This involves lying about their activities and trying to shift the narrative so that they are the victims, or at least they seem like the victims, when really they're the ones taking advantage of people. The fourth thing that they do is they present themselves as too good to be true. And we'll talk about this later, because that is a trait in and of itself that we will do a deep dive in. The second trait sociopaths have is the lack of empathy or remorse. Generally, those suffering from ASPD are less likely to experience remorse or empathy and more prone towards more primitive emotions like anger and rage, and less towards sadness, although there are few exceptions. The fact is, the lack of consideration towards others is a key indicator of someone who exhibits sociopathic tendencies. And sociopaths often fake empathy if they've learned what's socially acceptable, and if you'll pay attention, their expressions are often a little off. That's because there are two kinds of empathy. The first one being cognitive empathy, and the second one being emotional empathy. Cognitive empathy, unlike emotional empathy, can be learned, and it's usually what high-functioning sociopaths use to maneuver those around them to persuade them for personal gain and benefit without really thought or concern for their well-being. For example, a sociopath may take someone's money and gamble it away illegally without any regard to the suffering it will cause millions of people.
Dan, the podcast the other day, but what is really interesting is how this whole thing came about, which kind of got my interest up about he is a fraud. And I met earlier in the day with the head of the Commodity Futures Trading Commission, and I asked, why are you not dismissing this application out of hand?
Number three, what is the sociopathic eye look?
Romantic relationship?
Yes.
When?
For one.
The most common look that sociopaths give is an intense, unwavering gaze. Let me ask you this. Have you ever looked at someone and they just gave you this really weird, creepy vibe? And oftentimes, sociopaths have this cold, flat look that in their eyes seem to just look right through you. The look may also seem like, it might look like a blank expression or something that lacks emotion. Also, advanced, high-level, high-functioning sociopaths can fake it, but if you pay attention to their eyes, and as the saying goes, your eyes are the windows to your soul. If you pay attention to their eyes, you will see literally emptiness. Number four, sociopaths will present themselves as too good to be true. We touched on this earlier, and the question is, can sociopaths be altruistic? And the answer is a little more complicated than you might think. On a small scale, sociopaths can have friends who they may display selfless or altruistic behaviors towards. The reason why they can exhibit this behavior is because they develop feelings of love for others. So yes, sociopaths can fall in love, but for the majority, sociopaths really can display themselves as hero or savior, and they can actually truly believe it while not actually showing concerns for others in their actions. And because sociopathy is something that's developed later on in life, they can have some type of moral compass. But if there's no emotional connection to people, like strangers, for example, they'll present themselves as, again, too good to be true, the hero, the savior. And oftentimes, if you run into somebody that is just too good to be true, that they agree with everything that you agree with, that everything that you have interest in, somehow they have a solution for you, they can solve all your problems, then you may have just run into a sociopath. Now, don't get me wrong. Of course, there are genuinely good people in this world that want to help you, people that care about you, people that are selfless, and that's something that you'll have to discover over time in getting to know these people. Number five. Sociopaths' emotional responses are unnatural. The reason why they're unnatural is because sociopaths often have a difficult time displaying empathy, as we've talked about. And because of that, you need to pay attention to really unnatural emotional responses to certain things.
And so because she wasn't taking care of you and your family, you decided to kill her.
Like psychopaths, sociopaths have a difficult time displaying specific emotions, but oftentimes, negative emotions are heightened. Emotions like anger, frustration are often exaggerated, while emotions like happiness, joy, excitement, sadness, grief, remorse are much more muted. What you need to watch out for is high-functioning sociopaths, as we talked about. They're incredibly intelligent, and most will try to fake emotional responses, and that's why they can come off as unnatural or a little bit delayed at times, because they're processing it in their mind as opposed to just letting their emotions out.
Handles reacting to bad news.
I'm having intimate relations with La Guelta.
Congratulations.
Paul's dead.
Oh?
It's more a cognitive response. And honestly, beyond primitive emotions like anger or rage, sociopaths lack genuine feelings. Number six, sociopaths are extreme risk takers. The reason why sociopaths have such a high tolerance for risk is because high risk behaviors such as aggression, criminality, sexual promiscuity, drug use, and different types of addictions like gambling or intense gaming are often associated with sociopathic traits. And the question is why? Well, it's because generally sociopaths have grown up in a life without consequences. So their lack of fear for ramifications makes them normally highly impulsive.
24, 48 hours after I made the tweet, and then he wanted to talk. So at the beginning, I thought he would just wanted to, you know, do a buyout on, do an OTC deal to buy out the FTT tokens we had. And then he wanted actually a buyout of the entire firm, of the entire FTX platform. And then, but then we got our team on, and it was pretty clear pretty soon that there's, you know, this misappropriation of user funds. The user funds are gone.
For most people, we won't commit certain high-risk activities because of fear of consequence, fear of actions. But sociopaths are completely numb to that. Especially high-functioning sociopaths may develop their financial fortune from being extremely high risk takers. Now, friends, before we get into the bonus trait, I'd like to also point out, as a disclaimer, that this video isn't meant to diagnose anyone as a sociopath or give you the abilities to claim whether somebody's a sociopath or not. This video is entirely for entertainment purposes only. And if this video added a little value to your life, make sure to subscribe and hit that notification bell, because we make videos that are designed to take you to the next level. And now onto our bonus tip. Number 7, sociopaths ignore social norms and have blatant disregard for the law. The fact is, sociopaths are more likely to use, exploit, abuse, and harm other people because of their blatant disregard for social norms, other feelings, and the law. With the inability to empathize with others, most sociopaths completely ignore social norms and cues. Now, the question you might be asking yourself is, how does a sociopath disregard social norms? How does it look like? Well, one way is they may live their lives extremely different from others. Sociopaths have little disregard for politics or displaying the right behavior.
Hey, the time of my life. No, I never felt this way before.
Never felt
yes,
this
I swear. It's a truth. And I hope
friends, I hope you learned something valuable today. Let me know in the comments below some other sociopathic traits that you've noticed that I might have missed. If you enjoyed this video, you'll probably enjoy this one too. I love you. I respect you. Go out there and conquer. I'll see you next time. Bye for now.